When we talk about climate change, we usually talk about the need to reduce greenhouse gases. 1 ton of greenhouse gases takes up about this much space. Each year in Metro Vancouver, 15 million tons of greenhouse gases are released. And we want to reduce this by 80% by the year 2050. But how do you measure 15 million tons of GHGs? Well, it turns out you don't. They're calculated. GHGs are created when fuel is burned. If you know how much fuel is being burned, you can figure out how many GHGs are being created. So the planners at Metro Vancouver collect fuel consumption data from a whole bunch of sources. Add in some chemical formulas, and the massive emissions is estimated from that. For things that move around, like the family car, ships, trains, aircraft, heavy-duty trucks, bulldozers, and tractors, federal agencies like Transport Canada and provincial agencies like ICBC can tell us how many of these vehicles are in the region. Combine that with fuel consumption data and you get a pretty good estimate of total emissions. So that makes up about half of the GHGs. Next, coming in around 25% are things that stay put, namely buildings. Rooftop vents like these release CO2 in the process of heating and cooling buildings. Natural gas provider FortisBC reports information for most of these calculations. Industrial facilities also track their fuel use and report back to Metro Vancouver. And then the data nerds go to work to calculate the GHGs emitted by this sector. Lastly, data is collected on a range of other emission contributors like cement production, petroleum refining, landfilling, and agriculture. There's a bit more fine-tuning to meet United Nations International Climate Change protocols, but generally, that's how it works.